Welcome to Second Take, the show that takes a look at the issues behind the news. Gauteng Premier David Makuura has outlined the province's intention to entrench the development of mega human settlements under the Gauteng Department of Human Settlements Mega Project Strategy. Natalie Grieve joins me in studio to discuss the strategy. Hi, Natalie.
Hi, Tracy.
Can you talk us through how the Premier's new vision for housing development and settlement planning differs from the old strategy?
Sure. Well, it was launched this week, first of all, in Johannesburg, and the Gauteng provincial government has essentially outlined this mega projects program that is aimed at transitioning away from smaller developments to large-scale mega developments that are going to see at least 15,000 housing units, but as many as 60,000. The intention of this sort of paradigm shift in housing settlement planning is seen as a breakaway from the reconstruction and development program housing, where you saw sporadic monolithic developments, and a transition towards mega human settlements that will essentially have their own economy. So under this new program, we're going to see these big sprawling estates that will have healthcare facilities, education facilities, retail facilities, and even office blocks and some public services, such as Department of Home Affairs offices, for example. Also importantly, within these developments, we're not going to see the sort of one sort of type of housing. We're going to see mixed income housing. So we're going to see housing for both high income earners and low income earners, which I think is fundamental to the strategy that David Makuura outlined earlier this week. He said that he wants to break the sort of enclave of the rich, where you see, you know, rich high income earners living in these estates and then low income earners living far away from them, which is sort of a remnant of apartheid spatial planning a long time ago, and was exacerbated under the RDP program, which he describes as a bad dream.
And how does Gauteng intend to transition to the new mega project program?
Well, the transition process is expected to take about 3 years. The first phase will see the consolidation of existing micro projects within the mega projects portfolio. We're then going to see the complete closure of all the micro projects. By the end of year three, we're likely to see a full adoption of the mega projects program. So all housing developments after 3 years are going to be directed and guided by this new program.
And what are the flagship projects that are under development or under construction? And how will this improve the backlog in housing in the province?
Well, these human settlement cities are going to be built along five development corridors in Gauteng over the next 15 years. The first development corridor is the central corridor, which is going to be based around the city of Johannesburg. That'll see the development of three private sector-led human settlement cities. Some of them have already started, for example, Steyn City, Moorefontein City, and Waterfall City. There are then also going to be another three public sector-led cities, which have yet to be announced. And then we'll see the Eastern Corridor, which is going to be based around the Ekurhuleni Metro, the Northern Corridor, which will be developed around Tshwane, the Western Corridor, which will see the development of the West Rand, and then the Southern Corridor, which will develop the Sidibeng District. Now, collectively, these developments will deliver around 700,000 housing opportunities, and the current backlog in the province stands at around 680,000, so it will actually exceed the current housing demand.
And the Gauteng provincial government has made its intention clear of partnering with the private sector and local communities. Has David Makuura made any concrete commitments in this regard?
Well, he's remained quite vague about the specific opportunities that will be available for the private sector, but he's definitely said that there will be opportunities for developers, contractors, and construction companies. He has reiterated time and time again that public-private collaboration is the centerpiece of his administration, and he's also acknowledged that in the past there have been planning issues by municipalities, there have been administrative and bureaucratic issues in terms of contractors being awarded development permits and that sort of thing. One of the real commitments he's made or had made this week at the launch of the mega projects program was that environmental impact assessments would be given back to developers within 3 months. And then interestingly, the Gauteng MEC for Human Settlements, Jacob Mamabolo, said that this mega projects program is going to go some way towards alleviating the pressures currently felt by the industry that would have largely been blamed on a lack of infrastructure rollout by government. He says that, you know, government is willing to do its part in the revival of the sector, but this will actually require buy-in from the private sector and will require companies actually buying into this mixed income housing development model. Makura has obviously made it very clear as well that housing developers now need to come forward with proposals that don't just include developments for high income households, but also mixed income households that are going to disintegrate the apartheid spatial planning that has resulted in a lot of inequality that we see today.
Thanks, Natalie.
Thank you.
That's the Second Take show for this week. Thank you for watching and join us again next time for more news analysis.